Very good morning and welcome to the third meeting in 2022 of the Criminal Justice Committee. There are no apologies this morning. I ask members to please ensure that their mobile phones are switched to silent and wait for the sound engineer to switch your microphone on before speaking. So our first item this morning is to decide whether to take item four in private. Are we all agreed? Thank you very much indeed. Our next item is consideration of two petitions that were referred to the previous Justice Committee and carried over into this new parliamentary session, and I refer members to paper one. So this is the first time that we have looked at these petitions since we were established as a committee, and I'll be inviting members to shortly give their thoughts. So let me start with petition number PE1370 from the Justice for Megrahi campaign group submitted by Dr. Jim Swire. This important petition calls on the Scottish Government to urge this, I beg your pardon, the Scottish Parliament to urge the Scottish Government to open an independent inquiry into the conviction of the late Mr. Abdel Basset Al Mohamed Al Megrahi for the bombing of Pan Am Flight 103 in December 1988. The previous committee kept this petition open and effectively placed it on hold pending the conclusion of the different inquiries and the various legal cases that were being pursued in the courts. They felt they could not make a decision on the merits of the petition until those processes had been concluded. So as the paper by the clerk notes, some but not all of these legal processes have been completed. And members will note the letter received yesterday from Mr. Ian McKee on behalf of the Committee for Justice for Megrahi, confirming that the family continue to seek opinion from the Supreme Court. And we're grateful to Mr. McKee for this helpful update. So my suggestion for the committee is likely to be to continue to keep the petition open until we're clearer what steps, if any, the family of Mr. Al Megrahi plan to take in relation to any appeal to the Supreme Court. So I'd like to now invite views or comments from members. And I will bring in firstly Jamie Green, followed by Rona Mackay. Jamie.
Thank you, convener, and good morning, colleagues. I just wanted to note for the record that this is obviously the third session of Scottish Parliament and an iteration of the Justice Committee, which has looked at this petition. It is my view, and I will note the same comments for the next petition, that these should not remain indefinitely open for more than a decade. And indeed, I think it's in the best interests of the work of the committee and indeed the campaigners, with which I have no view specifically, to seek other recourse. It's clear that if three sessions of Parliament cannot address the wishes and needs of the campaign, I can't see our committee having the time and ability to do so either. I think there is, of course, some important considerations to take place, and I think that the legal representation that the family have are well within their rights to pursue all legal recourse that is available to them, and of course can make direct representation to the government and its ministers, noting that we do have a new Justice Secretary, I'm sure one of many which the petition has dealt with over the years. But I feel that would be the best line of pursuing the matter for them and not one for this committee, given that it is a very specific and direct case. I would suggest that if we don't close it today, that we do at least at the very least agree a future date by which we will have come to a decision as to what we recommend next, that gives us some future closure on it within the session of our committee in this session of Parliament.
Thank you very much, Jamie. Rona Mackay, I'll bring you in.
Thank you, Convener. I disagree with my colleague Jamie Green. I'm in favour of keeping this petition open. As you say, Convener, it's been a long running petition in the last session and before. And I think by the very unique nature of this, I think it would be wrong of us to close it at the minute when there are still conclusions to be made. I see no harm in keeping this petition open. Clearly the issues have not been resolved, and I think we sort of owe it to the campaign group and the families to keep this petition open, and I would not want it to be closed at this stage.
Thanks very much. That's very helpful. I think just to grateful for those points. I think just to clarify, obviously one of the main reasons that the petition was kept open because there were a number of processes, judicial processes underway, and had not at the time of consideration of the committee of the petition rather been concluded. So that my understanding was that was the basis on which the petition remained open. I note the comments of Jamie Green. I'm not altogether sure what alternative legal processes would be open to the family in particular and others, but I do note those comments. I do think that it's appropriate at this point that, as a new committee, we keep the petition open on the basis of the points that we have made. So, if members are agreed, I'd note Mr. Green's comments, and we will keep the petition open. Just before we conclude, I'm aware that Fulton MacGregor and then Russell Finlay want to come in, so I'll bring in Fulton first and then Russell.
Thanks, Convener. Yeah, it was just to really back up what Rona Mackay had said and that you went on to say. I think we should keep this petition open at this time. I was a member of the previous Justice Committee in the last term as well, in which this petition came up regularly and we had similar discussions. I wonder if it would also be worth maybe writing to the Scottish Government asking for an update as a committee, asking for an update on what their current view on the situation is as well, given the requests. But certainly in terms of the decision for today, I would be minded to keep it open. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Fulton, I'll hand over to Russell Finlay and then I'll bring in Pauline McNeill. Russell.
Yeah, hi there. I'm fairly ambivalent about the subject. I mean, on the one hand, it's the biggest mass murder terrorist atrocity in Scottish legal history, and there are clearly serious unanswered questions. The flip side is I do worry about the rise in judicial public inquiries in Scotland. It seems to be one of our few growth industries. Now, that might be a slightly flippant observation, but on balance, I think there's probably no harm in us maintaining it until the legal process has been exhausted, which is what the Justice for McGrahy group are asking for. So I think I tend to agree with yourself on that.
Thank you very much, Russell. That's helpful. I'll bring in Pauline McNeill and then Katie Clark. Pauline.
Yeah, I'm happy to support, you know, what you've said and actually what Russell Findlay said there. But I do think we need to review whether we can keep any petitions open for such a long period of time, but I'm content for the time being. I just wanted to say that. I don't think it's necessary to write to the Scottish Government. I think there's a judicial process and we need to wait. Well, what we've been asked to do is wait to see what the family do if they decide to lodge their appeal, which they are legally entitled to do. And I think we should leave it at that. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Pauline. Katie Clark, over to you.
Yes, I mean, I also agree with the convener's proposal to keep the petition open. I am new to this issue in that I wasn't obviously on the Justice Committee in any previous parliament, and was elected in May, although I'm aware of the issue from previous you know, sort of work. And if there was a proposal to do something different, I think we would need quite a bit of information. Well, I would personally feel I'd need to know more. And so at a future stage, you know, if there's a way of getting more information, that would be useful, because I've not been lobbied on the issue. I mean, the only, you know, lobbying really is the letter that the campaign sent in yesterday. So, you know, I think at this stage, I'm very comfortable with what's been proposed, given I've not been involved in the previous discussions. But if there was a suggestion that we were to do something different, then, you know, it would be useful to consider what information we need to make that decision.
Thanks very much, Katie. I'm grateful for the comments and views made by members. So I think on the basis of those points, we will agree to keep the petition open until we're clearer what progress has been made before we make any further decisions on the petition when it next returns. So I thank members for their assistance in that. Our second petition is petition number PE1458 from Mr Peter Sherby. This calls for the Scottish Parliament to urge the Scottish Government to create a register of pecuniary interests of Judges Bill, or amend present legislation to require all members of the judiciary in Scotland to submit their interests and hospitality received to a publicly available register of interests. The previous committee saw merits in the case made for such a register, and the call for such was part of the recent programme for government. My suggestion for the committee is likely to be to continue to keep the petition open and ask the Cabinet Secretary for Justice and Veterans for clear information on when he plans to take forward the commitment to this register and what form it will take. So again, I'd like to invite members to raise any comments or points that they wish on this. Russell, I'll bring you in. Russell Finlay.
Yes, thank you. I suppose I need to declare a bit of an interest in that I wrote the first press story about this petition when it was lodged in 2012. And as a journalist, I came to have regular contact with the petitioner, Mr. Peter Sherby, and continued to report on it for many years. Now, remarkably, and despite sometimes the best efforts of the judiciary, it's now almost 10 years old, which must be a record and perhaps says something about parliamentary committees. I'm not entirely sure what. Now, going forward, I agree entirely that we need to see exactly what the SNP government is proposing. I was surprised to see this in the SNP manifesto, and I found it very interesting because Nicola Sturgeon and successive justice secretaries have long been opposed to it in principle. And while there has been plenty said about this subject, and plenty more will be said about it, I think we should not lose sight of the fundamental issue, which is this is about transparency and accountability, and it's absolutely not about political meddling in judicial independence. I think the reason the petition has reached its 10th birthday almost is because many other MSPs from Trust Party, some who are no longer in the Parliament, understood this principle, and that is perhaps why it's still alive. As frustrating as that is, that, you know, something that seems to be generally agreeable that doesn't seem to have meaningfully progressed. So let's just see what is being brought forward.
Okay, thank you very much, Russell. I'll bring in Rona Mackay and then Jamie Green. Rona.
Thanks, Convener. Notwithstanding what Russell said, that there is progress now. It was in the SNP government's manifesto, do this. And on that basis, I don't think we should keep the petition open. I think we should follow up with a letter to find out timescales and when this is likely to be brought in. But you know, that's my view. I think it's been a long running issue and it has reached a conclusion, and we just need to progress it, find out when it's going to happen.
Okay, thank you very much, Rona. Jamie Green, if you'd like to come in.
Right, thank you, Convener. I think the difference between this petition and the last one, albeit the length of time and the straddling multiple sessions of Parliament, there is comparison there. The difference here is that there is a commitment from the government to introduce the outcome that the petition seeks. However, words on paper and deeds and actions are two very different things. So I would say until we have sight of either the legislation required or a more detailed proposal from the government, which even something as simple as a policy consideration that, that Parliament can consider, given that a manifesto clearly relates to a term of Parliament, but a programme for government is an annual statement, and this was in the 21-22 programme for government, and obviously there are only a few months of that left. So I would expect that we would see some sight of more detail on that. I think it would be in our interest to write to the Cabinet Secretary to ask them to outline the timescales for the actions that they've promised to undertake. And it's at that point, if we are satisfied that that delivers upon the petition, then we could perhaps consider it closed. But I think it should remain open for now.
Okay, thank you very much indeed, Jamie. I don't think there's anyone else wanting to come in. So on the basis of the points made, I think we are all agreed. I know, Rona, you're minded to close off the petition. My suggestion would be that we keep it open, and as members have commented on, we seek further clarity on what the plan is in terms of taking this matter forward by the, and we'll write to the Cabinet Secretary in that regard. So we're looking for progress and some further update on timescales. So if we're all agreed, my proposal would be to keep the petition open and write to the Cabinet Secretary. Are we all agreed on that? Perfect. Thank you very much. So our next item is consideration of a legislative consent memorandum on the Public Service Pensions and Judicial Offices Bill, and I refer members to Paper 2. The bill deals with mostly reserved matters, but it does propose a couple of changes to devolved competencies. For example, the amendment to the Public Service Pensions Act of 2013, explained in the LCM, relates to judicial pensions schemes and the ability to add additional devolved offices to the new judicial pension scheme. If passed, the Scottish Government will be proposing that mandatory retirement age for judges and sheriffs will be increased from 70 to 75 years of age. And the bill will also enable devolved judicial offices to be added to a judicial pension scheme. And this would be done through legislation considered in the UK Parliament. So I should note that the Parliament's Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee wrote to the Cabinet Secretary to seek an explanation as to why this is not being done by Scottish statutory instrument. And as members will be aware, we have received a copy of the reply from the Cabinet Secretary to the Delegated Powers Committee clarifying this point. So again, I would like to open it up to members to come in with any views or comments on the LCM. No particular comments? Okay, thank you very much. So the question now is whether the committee agrees to recommend to Parliament that the relevant provisions of the Public Service Pensions and Judicial Offices Bill should be considered by the UK Parliament. Are we all agreed? Okay, thank you very much indeed. And so I'll arrange for a short factual report to be published on our deliberations. So that concludes the public part of the meeting, and we will now move into private sessions and onto MS Teams. Thank you very much.